Good morning. First of all, I feel a little embarrassed or low in the sense that so many great speakers are sitting in front of me and I have been asked to speak the first. First of all, I can tell you a sportsman, I've been telling this to Rajiv also, and so many of you earlier, that for a sportsman it is much easier to play 2 hours of game, and even for me to write something about my game or my sports, rather than to give a long speech. But certainly, today, I would like to take you to my life journey. What I told Rajiv, what he mentioned just now, he was very kind enough to mention so many things about me. I think my life in sports, journey in sports started just before the partition, before the independence. I was a young boy. My father was a good hockey player. He in fact collected a lot of people. You must have heard about in hockey, about a village called Sansarpur. And along with that, there is a village, Khusropur. When I'm talking about, I was born in 35. Today I'm 75 year old. So, in say 44, 45, at that time, 1944, 45, my father used to play and he had Army Medical Corps, he was an officer there. And he collected all these players from Sansarpur and Khusropur and made a good team. I used to go and watch, small kid. My father used to take me on a cycle. And I got interested in the game. And then, of course, I started playing also a little on that red, muddy ground in the Army cantonment in Rawalpindi. And then, of course, the partition came. And we migrated to India. And then my father was going around the whole country, being posted to Danapur, then to Lucknow, and then to Mahu. A long journey, but at the same time, I think very, very valuable lessons for me, getting into contact with a lot of people and getting into hockey. In fact, in my school days, I must confess that I was not a good hockey player. I was as good a badminton player as a hockey player. But not as good probably I would have become as Keshav Dutt, who was a ranked player in India and who represented in 2 Olympics and 1 Olympic gold medals. But certainly, in Lucknow I was not a... but my ambition was that I will become a hockey player. And because I think how it came about, I must tell you that at that time all the sportspersons had only one ambition, because if you had to achieve something in sports, because Dhyan Chand was an aura which the whole country or the whole world had in hockey, and of course India. Because India was known in sports only through Dhyan Chand. Today maybe it is good that they are also known because of Sachin Tendulkar and also Gavaskar and other icons. But still, I think still in 1928, 32, 36 when India won the Olympic gold medals, it was only Dhyan Chand and Dhyan Chand. And every sport person wanted to go to hockey at that time, because in hockey you could represent the country in Olympics and achieve something. But for me it was a very, very, very humble beginnings, because as I told you that I was only good in badminton as well as in hockey. In Lucknow, I could get into the badminton team in my school and my college, but not in hockey. But then I went to the first match I played as a 14 year old boy in Lucknow was when my father's team in AMC, he also made a team AMC in Lucknow, and I got a very prized write-up in the local paper Because I was a 15-year-old and playing with the army team, they had one player shot, so my father told me, okay, you got into the ground. And I still remember, probably it was there that the worst player on the field was Gurbakhsh. I played the outside left. And then came Mahu. That was the army cantonment. Over there, a lot of army officers used to come, and I had the ambition. I went to Holkar College in Indore. And then the real ambition came into my mind that, yes, I can achieve something. And then also, another impediment in my life, in sports life, came that I started wearing spectacles. And I'm proud today that I'm probably the only hockey player, definitely, but probably in body contact games like football and hockey. Today, probably because the contact classes have come, people have started representing, who have won Olympic gold medal, Asian gold medal, with wearing specs also. So that was, I can think, but at that time it was definitely an impediment, because with specs I will play and they will sometimes fall down. Later on, when I started wearing this string, you find that I started tying, then my specs used to go into it. I'm taking you the complete through my life, how it came about. Maybe you'll be saying that what he's talking about, but I'm telling you what a sportsman can go through. Because at that time, probably people used to say that sportsmen are born. Today, sportsmen are made, champions are made. But certainly at that time also, you had to work hard. Your parents wouldn't allow you to play. I used to get rebuked because my sister, elder sister, and we were both in the matriculation we did together. And I will come, go and play. And in Lucknow, when I was there, a thought will come. Come on, because I'm not that type of speaker that will take you along. But Lucknow, I remember, after school, in class 10 and 11, I will come back home, then cycle 7 kilometers from the army cantonment to Charbagh station. Outside that, there was a ground. 7 kilometers cycling, play 1 hour, come back 7 kilometers cycling. Again, by the time I come home, my sister will be studying, and I'll be dozing. And my father will walk in, he said, and being a sportsman, he said, "Arey, padhna to hoga." So this is what a sportsman at that time had to go through. Today money is there, today fame is there, in every sport. So even the parents, they are also encouraging. But at that time it was difficult. And then came the Mahu. From there, the first vision of representing my college and representing the university came. From there I came to play intercollegiate in Meerut in 1955, and I first represented my college and got selected for the university, Agra University. And that changed also my career in hockey also, because I used to play as an inside right, inside left. If you're a sports person, you can understand in football and hockey that I used to play as a forward. And my teacher, one teacher was allowed, when he fell sick, so they asked that, okay, who will play a fullback? I said, okay, I'll raise my hand. Probably that changed my life. That changed, that got me gold medal, Asian gold medal. So the changes can also come in life. When you raise your hand, changes can come in your life, and it can make your life also, and it can destroy your life also, no doubt. But the decisions have to be taken. So I took that decision. I played as a fullback in that intercollegiate in Meerut. Got selected in the university as a fullback. And that started my journey. And one thing more. Today in sports, it's very, very little, particularly in hockey. It's practically finished in schools and colleges. But at that time, we were 6 players in that inter-university, like Prithipal, Charanjit, Joginder, and then there was Mohinderlal, myself, Dharam, who ultimately from that university, after about 9 years, they all played for the 64 Olympics. That was the condition at that time. All these players, and maybe more, but I remember these 6, we were there, who played inter-university against each other, and then represented in the 64 Olympics. So this is how my life started. But also in 1955, when again I came for this inter-university, I went for the national championship for the first time. I visited in Madhya Bharat, and I was not allowed to appear for my graduation because the attendance fell short because I was playing hockey. So I lost that year, but I made up when my father retired. I came to Meerut and I did my graduation in different subjects. I was a math student. Mathematics, physics, chemistry were my subjects. And then I couldn't appear. When my father retired, 55, in 56, I did my graduation privately with a Punjab university, having economics, English literature, and that I think Mr. Ashok Vishwara would be surprised that I did that, and I passed. And I came to Calcutta. And that probably changed my life further. Because that made my life, I will say, that once I came here, I played for the first year for East Bengal. Then the very next year, I joined Customs. And then Customs, when I started playing, I attended my first camp in 1959. Time is going. Okay, in 59, my first camp. And in that, I started representing the country and going for the camps. In that, Customs would not pay me for even 6 months. 6 months without pay, and then the letter will go to the government of India, to the president of India, will special casual leave, they will pay me after 6 months. So this is what we have gone through. But at the same time, I think sports has given me a lot of things, and that particularly it needs dedication, devotion, it needs your single-minded object. And I think it's also teaches you a lot of other things. One is that you have to know the individuals very nicely, closely. I have captain, I have been manager, I have been coach of the Indian team, I have been captain as a player also. But at the same time, I think it was very, very important that you know the individual. When you are a leader, you have to know, as a captain, you have to know the weaknesses. Because I found that some of the players were there to whom I will, please don't mind if I say, if I abuse them, you can take out double from them. And some other player was there, psychologically, if I abuse them, they will go down. So you have to know each player's capability. And some players only need to hit the bat and they will go up. They will play better. But at that time also, the money was not there. Today, unfortunately, the money is there. And you'll be not surprised to know that when we won the Olympic 64 medal in Tokyo, we were given a prize money of 30 pounds, British pounds, by the Indian Hockey Federation. Pound value was at that time 18 rupees. So 540 rupees was the prize money which we got at that time for our winning Olympic gold medal. So this was the time, but today the money is required. But at the same time, I think the tears came to my eyes only when I saw earlier when we were playing against Pakistan, we played all the best teams in the world in that particular match because in that tournament, in Tokyo Olympics, it was we played Spain, we played Germany, we played Holland in the pool matches, all the three top teams at the moment. Then Australia in the semi-final, Pakistan in the final. And at that time when the match ended, till that time, you see, I was watching the clock over there, was in front, 2 minutes left. Every time I look up, because it was right in front, I will find hardly 10 seconds have gone, 20 seconds have gone. But time was not passing. But after the time, it was over, you see, there was nothing in left. I thought everything was drained out. But definitely, when the national flag was raised and national anthem played, and we had to turn right to receive our Olympic gold medals, at that time, the tears came to my eyes. And I found that yes, probably I could achieve something for myself and also for the country. So this is how the journey has gone through. But at the same time, I think it's a very, very valuable experience what I got. And if at all anybody wants to ask any particular question, because it's very, very short time, I think, 3 minutes left. And I think it's very, very important for me that I came here. I got all the respect and all the love and affection from the people of Calcutta and Bengal. But if I had not come here, probably I wouldn't have played. And at that time, one thing I regret. In 1959, in my first camp, when I was not selected, At that time, Ashwini Kumar, he was the president of Indian Hockey Federation, he called me. He said, oh, you left the camp for going for your engagement. I said, I took that permission from Mr. Balbir Singh. He was the camp in charge. And I said, sir, if I'm not selected because I'm wearing specs, I will never ever come to the any camp again. He said, no, the words he spoke, and they are still ringing in my ears. At that time, he said, Gurbaksh, it is not because of your specs you are not selected. You play the same game and show these selectors how wrong they were not in selecting you. These were the exact words he spoke, and I have been reminded of those words. And again, I tried. In fact, if you ask me, I should have played four Olympics. I could have played four Olympics. 60, I was cheated off, or I was deprived of. 72, I was asked again by Mr. Shem Ashwini Kumar that you have to go for the Olympics. I had announced my retirement at the top of the world. When we lost in 68, I was disheartened. We won only the bronze medal. And at 69, while India's captain, I announced my retirement. And then in 72, again, when Mr. Ashwini Kumar, I had played the nationals. And when he again called me, he called me personally. He said, okay, you have to go to the 72 Munich Olympics. And I said, no, I will announce my retirement. I will not come back. And I think I don't regret it. I don't want to regret. And even in life, I think one has to take a decision. I think I took the right decision because at that time, like today, I tell you, the best of cricketers, the best of players, the best of things, if they are being pushed around, I think it is nobody's fault. The player has to take a decision themselves. In human being, he has to take a decision in life. I'm going to play, I'm not going to play. Those decisions, if you take at the right time, I think it may later on turn out that you have not taken the right decision. But I think those decisions are very, very important and to be taken at that time. Anything else anybody wants to ask? I can continue for a lot of other things, but if you can ask, I think I'll prefer if you can ask me something.
Sir, we have a couple of questions. Yes. Which we've collected from the audience. So, one of them is, in all these years of sportsmanship, which is the one biggest lesson that you have learned and how has that changed you?
I think the biggest lesson I have learned is that sportsmanship is not only the word, the hollow around it. It is also has to be practiced. Forget and forgive. That is also sportsmanship. Because if somebody has done something to you, I have tried in my life, and I have tried that. I have played for more than 41 years first-class hockey in Calcutta. And I found so many people have tried to be against me, talked about me, but I always thought that, okay, this is part of life. And I think that is what has helped me, that has kept me calm, and also on the ground, that is also, in difficult times, also it helped me. Please don't mind, because I bought it, because I think the audience will be from a very, very wide range, and I think you'll be happy to see this.